Love Smarter, Not Harder Q&A from the car, but I'm not driving. Dan is, so don't worry. So, here goes. Happy New Year. I can't sleep. I just need a little clarity. So I've been seeing this guy. He lives about 4 hours away from me. Super sweet, good to my kids, would do anything for us. But for the past couple of months, I've been unhappy. It's been almost a year since I've known him, but he doesn't always tell me the whole truth. He always has to know what I am doing, but leaves out his own stuff. I used to go to bed around 9, but he's a night owl. And since I've met him, I'm up till about 10, 10:30, and there have been a few times when he goes out after I go to sleep. I'm assuming after they talk and then hang up, and then he goes out, yeah, she says, to a bar, never tells me he's going, and I never know the next day either. It's usually a couple of days later when he starts talking about it, or I see pictures on Facebook. Now, it's always with his siblings, but it makes me uncomfortable. Not only going out so late, but the fact that he doesn't even tell me. Now, first of all, it's a little odd that he just wouldn't, if he's cool with going out, which is not a big deal. I mean, I don't know what his work schedule is, but if he can go out to bars late at night, that's his choice. But why, and he's just going with a sibling, why wouldn't he say something to you? Also, if you guys aren't exclusive, I don't know what the long distance arrangement is. If you are exclusive, then yeah, you have every right to know because he's going out late and you should know. You're his girlfriend, you are committed. But if you're not exclusive, then it's one of those situations where you really can do what you want and you don't have to tell him everything and he can do what he wants and he doesn't have to tell you everything. So where your relationship stands is important on this, but let's keep going. There was also a time where his kid's mom was at the house inside and I didn't even know about it, even though we texted in the morning. All these things make me feel like I'm unimportant to him. It's hard enough living so far away, but I feel like since we live far apart, he should be going harder in his efforts since we don't get to see each other that easily. I've tried to speak to him numerous times about this and he just says it'll work out and or he'll work on it and that I should just trust him, that he's not doing anything wrong, saying I'm demanding too much and that I don't need to know everything he's doing in his life. Well, first of all, again, what's with the secrecy? I mean, if his ex has to come over and be at his house because they have kids together, then it's not a big deal, but is he keeping it a secret? There's no point. That's just shady. It just feels weird, and of course it makes you feel uncomfortable because it makes you feel like he's hiding something from you because he's not forthcoming with information that should be very basic and very benign. Like, yeah, he goes out with his siblings and has a drink because he's able to do that at 10 o'clock at night. Okay, no big deal. Or also, his ex is over there with the children because they co-parent. Again, no big deal. But it does make you feel uncomfortable, and I don't blame you. But the other piece I don't like about this is this whole, am I being too demanding? And he says that you're being too demanding. Well, okay, so in my last podcast episode, episode 74, How to Build a Strong Marriage While You're Still Single, I cover the research, which I love, the research that shows that people who have high expectations for dating end up with high quality marriages because they've decided, I want, this is my standard and this is what I want. You know, when we're single, we have a good life going. And my girlfriends and I used to always say, listen, if he's not part of the solution, he's part of the problem. And right now, what you're telling me sounds like he's part of the problem. And you've got your life, you've got your stuff together. You're living this extraordinary life. So if he's not at your same level, then for him to expect or to suggest that you have too high of standards, I don't like that. I think that that's trying to demean you and it's his way of trying to say, quit harping on me. I don't want to be at that level and you shouldn't expect that or want that either. And that's tearing you down. I don't like any of that. So take a listen to that podcast episode. And for anyone who's out there, keep our expectations and our standards high. That doesn't mean that we're like, oh, he's got to make this much money and he's got to buy me, name brand this or drip me with diamonds. It's not about that. It's about a quality individual, a man with integrity who you can trust and who wants to be a great man on his own because he wants to be a high quality person. And then also loves that you have high expectations and high standards and you both want to have this high quality, high standard relationship or eventually marriage. Okay, let's keep going. So he says that I don't need to know everything he's doing in his life. And he's told me before that I need to lower my standards and that I expect him to be perfect. Okay, that just seems manipulative to me. That's just very immature to me. It's like, you know, like a teenager, you expect me to be perfect. No, I have high expectations for you. If you're a parent, you have high expectations for your kid because you love them and you expect the best from them. And you're allowed to expect a lot from your partner. And Dan and I in our marriage, we expect a lot from each other. We both expect each other to be driven about our careers and be passionate about what we care about and our values. We have high expectations for each other physically. We both want to stay in shape so that we can live a long, long life together. We talk about making it to 100 together. I mean, that's what you want, is someone who has those same values and wants to hustle for them. So I just don't like that he's telling you to lower your standards. I mean, that's just a huge red flag for me. So she's saying that they've been on bad terms for the last couple months. And he always gives me empty promises and his actions never match up. I don't like that either. You know, actions speak louder than words kind of thing. And these empty promises. And, you know, the point of dating, I want to remind all of us, the point of dating is to see if it's a match, to spend time with someone so that whatever they're telling you, you can see if their behavior is consistent with that. Because talk is cheap. I mean, all those cliches are there for a reason. So the fact that he's giving you empty promises, you know, the point of dating is to figure out if he's a high quality man of integrity. And it's not sounding like he is. And also, I don't like that he's essentially lying to you. And remember, dating is the A game, right? He should be putting his best foot forward, trying to woo you and trying to get you to be his. And if he's giving you this in his A game, I don't see it getting any better from here. So, a couple weekends ago, he was supposed to come spend the weekend with me after not seeing him for weeks. And come that Friday, I don't hear from him at all day, which is not like him. But at 6 p.m., he texts me that he went out the night before, got trashed, totaled his car, and ended up in jail. He had just gotten out, and he was like, I hope you really love me because I effed up so bad, and I'm so sorry. Like, I feel when your girl and you aren't on the best terms, that you tell her all the time how you're meant to be together and that I'm his soulmate, that you wouldn't do something that we've been talking about and arguing about. But instead, you should put the effort into making the relationship better. And I agree with you. I mean, this is not stable, healthy, mature adult behavior to be totaling the car and getting trashed, totaling the car and getting thrown in jail. This is drama. I mean, you gotta think about, this is drama now. You've got kids. I mean, is this man gonna have your kids in his car someday when he's drinking? I mean, you really have to think seriously about when you're talking about a lifelong commitment. So then he says, she says, that's his problem. He never puts in effort. He's all talk. He just doesn't comprehend anything I'm saying, and he keeps saying he wants to be with me. Even last night for New Year's, he was supposed to show up, but his kid's mom never came, and I get it. But I never got a Happy New Year at midnight, because his phone was dead, like no effort at all. He had all day, and it wasn't until after 12 he sent me a Happy New Year's text. I feel a lot of these issues would go away if I lived closer, and I don't think that's the case. There's so much I don't like about this for you. You deserve so much better than this. This is, again, think about it. Is he adding to your life? Is he enhancing your life? Is he a strong partner that is helping you achieve your goals? No, he is a huge distraction, and it's painful to read this because I want better for you. And I know, think about what your best friend would tell you. She'd be like, girl, you deserve so much better than this. And we women have to keep our standards high, because if we allow guys to be immature like this, then they will be. And that's going to sound really sexist and people won't like that, but I don't mean it's sexist. I just mean that we all need to expect the best out of each other and not accept immature, inappropriate, pretty cruel behavior. Really, it's cruel the way he's treating you. And in episode 27 of my podcast, I talk about that marriage and relationships shouldn't be all that hard. You know, we hear that a lot, like, oh, it's just so hard, relationships are so difficult. And I'm here to tell you, I started dating at 15 and I got married at 42, and I've been in hard relationships, and now I'm married to the easiest relationship I've ever been in. Why? Because like I said earlier, we share the same values. We want the same things from life. And this is a man who doesn't want the same things from life, and he wants to act like you should lower your standards because you're expecting too much from him. I'm just not down for that. I don't think if you lived closer it would be any easier. He just keeps saying that every couple has issues and that no one is perfect, and that's what I'm expecting of him. Again, that's an immature comment, and every couple has issues. Yeah, every couple does have issues, and some are huge issues and some are just little issues that you work out and you hold each other's hand and you get through them together and you're stronger for it. Lastly, when we would fight, he would go and friend the same girl and love her stuff and comment on her pictures. He said it was just to get back at me. Again, that's so immature. That is not the kind of behavior that is a partner, a true partner in life behavior. That is catty, it's petty, it's childish. You don't need that. You don't need, I mean, come on. He literally told you it's just to get back at you. No. And he also told me that he goes out drinking every night because he gets lonely and depressed. And so, okay, drinking to handle your depression is not a plan. This is, again, immature behavior. We need to go to a therapist and we need to talk some of these things out and figure out what's going on with our depression and what, take charge of our thoughts, go to some cognitive behavioral therapy and get a handle on it. He just doesn't seem like a man. He seems like a boy. And a woman can't be with a boy and expect a relationship to work. She says, I'm sorry this is so long, and I tried to shorten it to get the main stuff, but help me get some clarity on this guy. He has a good heart, and I know he means well, but he's dumb as F, and I can't stand feeling this way. Is it me? Sorry, one last thing. Ever since we've met, things have always felt so comfortable between us. I have bad anxiety and panic attacks, and he's always consoled me and made me feel so much better. Please help. So, yes, I get that even in a relationship where there's a lot that's wrong and a lot that's off and a lot that's painful and a lot that's hurtful and a lot that I don't want for you, there are some good things. And that's what's hard. You know, I did a post a while ago that breakups are hardest when the relationship was almost right. And so when you have something like this, where with the panic and the anxiety that is a huge issue that you deal with, and then someone seems to have that thing that helps you calm and soothe, that's a really special quality. And I bet part of you thinks you'll put up with all this other crap that he serves up because that one thing is so, you need that so much. You need that safety and that security. But I would submit to you that it's nice that he can do that on the one hand, but I can also hear from everything you're sharing in this DM that he also causes a lot of anxiety for you and a lot of stress and a lot of panic because all this not keeping his promises, not being true to his word, telling you that you're demanding too much, going out at night, crashing the car, getting drunk, not letting you know when the baby mama's at his house. I mean, there's a lot of stuff here that is contributing to what you're dealing with on a psychological level as well. She says, am I asking too much, demanding too much? I'd love to know if it's me so I can change my ways and become better. And oh my gosh, that just breaks my heart to hear. You do not need to change your ways. The only way I would like you to change is to expect and believe that you deserve a man who is grown up and mature and knows what he wants from life and isn't using alcohol as a way to manage his psychological problems. You deserve so much more than that. And so no, absolutely not. When we started this talk months ago, at the talk about all the things that she's dealing with him, it just kept happening. He just told me that he's trying to change and do better, but it takes time and I need to be patient. But in the same breath, he's always constantly telling me I'm his soulmate and he wants me to move in with him and marry him. And he's been saying that since they were dating at 2 months, which I don't like either. And I've talked about this before in posts. I've had people in the past come on too strong, too soon. See, I don't like, at 2 months, no one should be talking about moving in with anybody or getting married. You're still getting to know each other. And I know how it feels when you have that infatuation that kicks in. It's okay to think about it, like, wow, I'm really into this guy. Like, within 2 months of meeting my husband, I was thinking about that, but I wasn't talking about it yet. And he wasn't talking about it yet, even though he was thinking about it, because the connection was so strong and so solid. But we don't want to be saying that because it's too early. In 2 months, someone can pretend to be anybody. And so we need to make sure. So when someone comes at us that early, that strong, that makes me nervous, because to me, it's like, you don't know me well enough yet. It's okay to be thinking that you like what you see so far, and that, wow, if you keep seeing more of the same, this could be a fit for life, but you shouldn't be talking about it yet, because you don't know enough yet. And a lot of times we're projecting onto the person what we hope they'll be. You know, the first couple months have been so good. I've seen this, and I'm assuming he's great in these other areas, but you don't know yet. So you have to be really careful. You have to sit on your hands in the first couple months of a relationship. So when a guy comes at you that early, it's a red flag to me, because he's basically trying to blow you up, or love bomb is what Fairy Godfather talks about, love bombing. Like, oh, well, let me just shower her with praise and get her all excited about me and tell her I love her so much already, and then I want to move in with her and make her my wife before I even know her well enough to even have that kind of conversation. Also, moving in with someone and being married is not the same thing. And, you know, a lot of guys are fine having someone live in their house and cook their meals and give them sex and do their laundry. And a lot of women take that like, oh, it'll be the next step. Sometimes it is, but the research also on this isn't very promising, actually. In fact, research is if we live together before marriage, we're less likely to get married in the first place. And if we do get married, we are more likely to get divorced than if we don't shack up. Now, I know that's controversial, and people think intuitively like, oh, we should test it out before we get married. But what happens is once you live together, you have a harder time breaking it off. When if you weren't living together, you might see those things and go, okay, we shouldn't get together. You make that break when you see that it's not the right person. I just want to remind you guys, dating is a trial basis. It is not you're dating and then you're getting married. You want to see what this person's about. And what you're seeing here, please don't look at it through rose-colored glasses. It's not good. So I don't like that he's already talking like this, or at 2 months he was talking about that. And then she says, even when we do fight and don't talk, he still texts me daily and tells me he loves me and misses me. And when I finally talk again, he gives me all these promises, but his actions don't match up. And again, no. You can do so much better. And this was a long one, but I know it's important to really flesh out all of this. So please love yourself enough to know that you deserve so much better. Love Smarter, Not Harder Q&A from the car. All right. I hope that was helpful.